Hello and welcome back. Today we will discuss a very important aspect of the disciplinary proceedings, which is called the financial effect of the penalty. As you can very well understand, that the last logical conclusion of a disciplinary proceedings, or the last step of the disciplinary proceedings, is final order by the disciplinary authority, either exonerating the government servant or imposing a penalty on it. नाउ आज हम फाइनेंशियल इफेक्ट्स ऑफ पेनल्टी की बात करेंगे. आप अच्छी तरह से ये भी जानते हैं कि पेनल्टी दो प्रकार की होती है. देयर आर टू काइंड्स ऑफ पेनल्टी, वन माइनर एंड वन मेजर. अंडर द सीसीएस सीसीआर रूल्स 1965 इन द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एंड बाय एंड लार्ज इन ऑल अदर डिपार्टमेंट्स, वेदर इट इज एन ऑटोनोमस बॉडी, बैंक एटसेट्रा, देयर इज सम माइनर चेंजेस, बट जनरली द पेनल्टीज हैव बीन डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स, मेजर एंड माइनर. सो दीज आर द टू कैटेगरीज ऑफ. Now there are five minor penalties and five major penalties. Five minor, five major. Now minor penalties are censure, withholding of promotion, recovery from pay of any pecuniary financial loss caused to the government. The fourth minor penalty is reduction by one stage for a period not exceeding 3 years without cumulative effect and not adversely affecting his pension. So you can see there are almost four conditions. One, the minor penalty of reduction can be only by one stage. It cannot be for two stages or three stages. It has to be only for one stage. And that also cannot exceed 3 years. In other words, it can be maximum for a 3 years. So you can stop the one increment, you can reduce the one in stage. One stage means one increment for a period of 1 year, 2 year or 3 years. And that also, it cannot be cumulative. That means after the penalty is over, the government servant does not suffer a permanent damage. So only the 3 years his increments are held or reduced. After the 3 year or 2 year or 1 year period is over, after the penalties period is over, he gets back the salary that he would have got had he not been penalized. And the fourth condition is, even if this penalty is imposed, it will not adversely affect his pension. That means the pension would be calculated on the pay that he would have got. Even at the time of this retirement, his penalty is there. He will get the salary, as calculation of pension will be done on the salary he would have got had there been no penalty. The fifth minor penalty is withholding of increments of pay. So these are the five minor penalties. First three penalties, you can see, censure, withholding of promotion and the recovery from pay. These three minor penalties, of course, they have a indirect effect on the government servant's career, growth, etc., etc. But they do not have an immediate pay reduction in the post the government servant is working. So if censure is imposed on me today, I will continue to get my pay as I am getting, I will continue to get my increments on the date of my increment. Similarly, for withholding of promotion, it will adversely affect my chances of promotion to the next grade. But in the post in which I am working, I will continue to get my pay, I will continue to get my increments on time. But coming to the fourth one, reduction by one stage. Now, once this penalty order is issued, the department will also have to issue a separate pay fixation order of the government servant as to where his pay will get reduced. Both the fourth and the fifth one would require the department to issue a separate order fixing the pay of the government servant during the period of penalty. Now, to do this pay fixation, we would have to basically have the pay matrix that is being followed after the seventh pay commission with us. Now you can see this is the pay matrix for all levels of pay post. There are 18 levels of post and each post will have its pay from time to time, from year to year, each stage already defined by the Government of India through this notifications. For example, if you see the level 1, now level 1 will have the beginning, the initial stage is 18,000. Next year, after getting an increment, it will be 18,500. Then again next year it will be 19,100, then 19,700, like this. So let us try to understand how the financial effects of penalty takes place by taking a specific example, in which let us assume that a government servant is in level 9 and he is drawing the salary of 61,500 after getting his increment on 1st of January 2020. So what I will do today, on the screen we will keep two things ready with us. One is the pay matrix. So let me reduce the pay matrix and keep only the level 9 before us, so that to save the space. Now you can see we have the level 9 before us, and I'm sure that you can see all the. We will also keep a white sheet where we will do the calculation. So this is the white sheet of paper where we will do our calculation to understand. So you can see the level 9, all the pay stages, and let us take this example that there is a government servant on whom there is a penalty which has been imposed by the discipline authority, reduction by one stage from 61,500, it has been reduced to 59,700. So you can see here, this is the stage. From 61,500, one stage has been reduced to 59,700. Now, to understand the effect of this pay from time to time, we have prepared a table here. And in this table, we are going to write the pay of the government servant with reference to each date, or let us say each 6 month or 1 year period, what will be his salary. So we have prepared this table, and in this table we are going to write three columns. One is the column for date, 1st January 2021. That is, this is the date of his increment. And on this date, what will be his salary? If there is a penalty, if there is no penalty. So we have two columns here. One this one and one this one. So this column we are writing the pay that he will draw during penalty. And in the next column we are writing the pay that he would have drawn had there been no penalty. Now dear friends, first let us write the pay that he got after increment, normal increment. Penalty has not been imposed till now. So on 1st January 2021, he is drawing, as I told you, 61,500. So we are writing here 61,500. This is the salary he is drawing on 1/1/21. And let us now assume that on 1st April 2021, the penalty has been imposed on him. So let us put a star mark here just to understand that on this date, the penalty has been imposed on him. Now what we are going to do from time to time, every month, let us say, we are going to write what is his salary if he is getting pay during penalty, and what will be his pay if there is no penalty on him. And what we are going to write is the pay that he would get during the penalty under this column, and what will be his pay if there is no penalty in the next column. So what are the relevant dates here? So relevant dates would be 1st January of the year 2022. Then again, the 1st January 2023. Now these are the dates of his increments. Now you can see if the penalty order is imposed from this date, 1st April 2021, then the 1 year period would end on 31st March 2022. So kindly see, I am writing the dates, relevant dates only. We can write it month wise, we can write it day wise, but here I am writing the important dates when there would be some change of pay. So on 1st April this penalty starts. So the 1 year period, we should be very clear in our mind that a 1 year period, this would be the 1 year period. So this 1 year period I have distinctly, very clearly, visually written before you so that you can understand. Now, if the penalty is imposed on him, then on 1st April 2021, he will not get 61,500 because it has been reduced by one stage from 1st April. So what should be his pay here? You can see from 6150, it has been reduced to 59700. So on 1st April, he should be getting 59700. So on 1st April under the column 2, pay during penalty, he will get 59700. And if there is no penalty on him, we should write the salary here. Kindly see, this column is for pay if no penalty. So on, if there is no penalty on the government servant, he would continue to get 61500. And kindly note, I am using different colors. Red color for the penalty, obviously red for danger, and green for no penalty. Now on 1st January 2022, the penalty is continuing. So what salary he will get here? Will he get his increment on 1st January 2022? The answer is obviously no, he cannot get increment. It has been reduced by one stage for a period of 1 year. So he will continue to get 59700 on 1st January 2022. And on 1st January 22, what will be his salary in the second column? Obviously, if there is no penalty, he would get his increment, and therefore his salary will be one level up. That means from 61,500, it will be 63,300. Now let us complete the remaining cells also. On 31st March, what he will get? He will continue to get 59700, and in this side, his salary will be 63300. So the period of penalty is over on 31st March, and then comes the next date, that is 1st April 2022. He is a free man, there is no penalty on him. Now what salary he will get on 1st April 2022? Since it's a minor penalty, it is without cumulative effect. Remember, it is without cumulative effect. Remember that? Kindly see, it is without cumulative effect. Then on 1st April 2022, since the period of penalty is over, he will get what he would have got had there been no penalty. Penalty khatam hone ke baad, kyunki ye cumulative effect ka nahi hai, to usko kya salary milegi jo wo leta? जो वो लेता अगर उसको पेनल्टी नहीं लगती, तो हम सेकंड वाले कॉलम में देख सकते हैं वो क्या लेता अगर उसको पेनल्टी नहीं लगती, तो वो 63,300 लेता, हम ये वाली सैलरी उसको दे देंगे. सो ऑन 1st अप्रैल 2022 ही विल गेट 63,300. और ध्यान दीजिए, 63,300 उसको मिल जाएगा 1st अप्रैल को, और उसकी इंक्रीमेंट की डेट वही रहेगी 1st जनवरी 2023. अगली इंक्रीमेंट उसको 1st जनवरी 2023 में मिल जाएगी, और उसकी सैलरी हो जाएगी 65,200. यानी कि जो भी लॉस उसको हुआ, वो केवल इस साल, एक साल के पीरियड में 12 महीने में उसको लॉस हुआ. जैसे ही ये पीरियड खत्म हुआ, ये वाला पीरियड जैसे ही खत्म हुआ, उसको वही सैलरी मिलेगी जो उसको मिलती अगर पेनल्टी नहीं लगती. Now friends, let us make it little more interesting. Let us now assume the discipline authority has not imposed this penalty for 1 year. The discipline authority has imposed this penalty for 2 years. 2 saal ke liye penalty lagai hai. Reduction by one stage. Kyunki you can only reduce it by one stage. Do you remember that? You can only reduce it by one stage. Reduction by one stage only. So one stage, but now for 2 years. So if it is for 2 years, then let us write the 2 year dates also. This was the first year date, 1st April 2021 to 31st March 2022. So if the penalty is for 2 years, it will start from 1st April 2022 and it will go up to 31st March 2023. So this is the second year block. Now if the penalty continues on second year also, on 1st April, what salary he will get? Whatever he was getting on 31st March. Increment date to abhi aaya nahi hai. So this he will continue to get 59700. If there is no penalty, he would have got 63,300. Now on 1st January 2023, now is the very important question I am asking to all of you. 1st January 2023, remember, his pay has been reduced by one stage only. You cannot reduce by two stages. एक ही स्टेज आपने रिड्यूस किया, लेकिन 2 साल के लिए. तो 1st जनवरी 2023 को सैलरी, इसको इंक्रीमेंट मिलेगी या नहीं मिलेगी? Will this during the penalty, will he get one level up above 59700 or not. So on 1st January, his salary, what will it be? Take your time, iska jawab dijiye. The answer is, he will not get increment, it will remain 59,700. As per DOPT orders, on 1st January also he will not get any increment, although the penalty is for one stage only. And therefore on 31st March, up to 31st March 2023, he will continue to get 59,700. In other words, if the penalty is for 2 years, but reduction is only for one stage, all these 2 years he will continue to get 59,700. So let us fill this up. On 31st March, if there is no penalty, he will get 65,200, but if there is penalty, he will get 59,700, 2 increments less. Then what he would have got, and then will come after 2 year period is over, again will this will date arrive 1st April 2023, what salary he will get, we have seen. After the penalty is over, since it is without cumulative effect, he will get the salary that he would have got had there been no penalty, that is 65,200. Now dear friends, kindly note that this penalty can also be for 3 years. So reduction by one stage for a period of 3 years. And this is a small task, homework for you. Draw his salary from time to time if the same penalty is for 3 years. So we'll meet next time and we'll talk about the next penalty, that is withholding of increment. What are the various implications of it? Till then, bye-bye. Thank you very much.